The year of 2025 was definitely one to remember in terms of volcanoes, with many unexpected, unusual, and also fascinating eruptions occurring. We got to witness repeated 1,000 to 1,500-foot high lava fountains originate from Hawaii's Kilauea volcano in tourist-viewing friendly eruptions. We also got to witness a volcano with no confirmed historical eruptions produce the largest eruption of the year somewhat unexpectedly in Africa. And we even got to directly witness one of modern history's largest reliably measured earthquakes directly trigger a volcanic eruption. That doesn't even get into the widespread evacuations that significant magma intrusions caused in two world volcanoes earlier in the year, Fentale in Ethiopia and Santorini in Greece. With all this being said, here are only a select few of the many top news stories that the world tuned into due to volcanic unrest and volcanic eruptions this year. In fact, throughout the entirety of 2025, a total of 67 distinct volcanoes produced eruptions across 27 different countries. The three nations with the most distinct volcanoes that erupted were Indonesia with 10, Japan with 5, and Russia also with 5. Across all these eruptions, an area of 106.9 square kilometers of land were incinerated via rapidly moving superheated gas currents known as pyroclastic flows, with the eruptions of Hayli Gubbi in Ethiopia, Lewotobi in Indonesia, and Semeru in Indonesia destroying the largest three swaths of ground. During the same time span, an area of 24.64 square kilometers was covered in fresh lava flows, with Nyamuragira in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Reykjanes in Iceland, and Krasheninnikov in Russia leading the pack statistically. While those three volcanoes produced the largest effusive eruptions, the largest explosive eruptions of the year originated from Hayli Gubbi, Lewotobi, and Semeru. So yes, due to unique circumstances, the largest explosive eruption of the year, reaching a low NVEI-4 on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index, strangely originated from a basaltic shield volcano. The three tallest eruption plumes this year originated from Hayli Gubbi with the third tallest plume, and Lewotobi with the second tallest plume and the single tallest plume. 2025 started with a major magma intrusion in Ethiopia that technically began on December 17, 2024. During the subsequent 2 months, 400 million cubic meters of magma intruded into a magma dike which expanded to 50 kilometers in length. 75,000 people were soon evacuated due to the possible threat of a volcanic eruption, and hundreds of magnitude 4-plus earthquakes struck alongside at least 56 hydrothermal explosions or possibly phreatic eruptions, forming craters between 1 and 41 meters wide. These continued intermittently for some time, and as this occurred, methane and other gases began emanating from and pooling within Fentale's summit caldera. Then, on February 14th, the largest earthquake to strike Ethiopia since 1989 occurred, causing a 1.73-kilometer-wide stretch of Fentale's summit to collapse downwards by as much as 26 feet. This was a CLVD quake with pure subsidence caused by underlying magma withdrawal into the aforementioned magma dike. Evacuated people eventually returned as activity subsided, although a much slower magma intrusion is still ongoing. Also in January, a 313 million cubic meter body of magma intruded to depths of as low as 5 kilometers northeast of Greece's Santorini volcano, leading to the generation of more than 30,000 earthquakes as the 13-kilometer-long magma dike propagated. Thousands of residents on Santorini soon evacuated, and with a state of emergency declared, some earthquakes even caused limited damage and landslides. Thankfully, no eruption or truly major earthquake happened, and residents later returned back to their homes. A second story that began late last year was the initiation of episodic activity at Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. Starting on December 23rd and still ongoing at the present, this has involved 39 and counting episodes of eruptive activity that, while intermittent, have always ended in hours-long sustained periods of lava fountaining. This is the first time Kilauea has produced episodic activity since 1986 and led to once-in-a-generation high gas content lava fountains. 13 of these 39 episodes produced 1,000 foot or higher lava fountains, with the tallest 1,500 foot high lava fountain of the year being witnessed by myself in person on October 17th. These intermittent tourist viewing friendly eruptions are likely to continue into 2026. Indonesia's Lewotobi Laki-Laki volcano also continued a cycle of major eruptions in 2025, producing five such major eruptions, most of which were subplanean. These sadly resulted in three fatalities, and each produced major pyroclastic flows which altogether incinerated an area of 25.05 square kilometers, even reaching some structures. In Iceland, the rate of eruptions at the Reykjanes fissure system continued to decline, with only two eruptions taking place in 2025. Thankfully, lava walls meant to divert lava flows away from structures once again proved their effectiveness, with 4.07 square kilometers covered in a new layer of basaltic lava. The sixth strongest earthquake ever recorded by modern equipment, a magnitude 8.8 megathrust event, struck offshore of Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula on July 30th. This led to a tsunami with up to a 109-foot high run-up height in one spot, but more interestingly, seemingly triggered some form of activity at six regional volcanoes. One of these, Krasheninnikov, erupted for its first time in more than 550 years after showing no signs of life beforehand. It subsequently produced Strombolian, Volcanian, and Phreatomagmatic eruptive activity after its new eruption initiated 3 days later, and in the time since created multiple blocky and viscous lava flows that expanded downslope in multiple directions. With the eruption still ongoing, at least 3.67 square kilometers of lava flows were in place across six distinct lobes. On July 14th, unusual ash emissions were generated from Ethiopia's Erta volcano as its two summit lava lakes rapidly subsided. Magma was draining away to the southeast, going into a lengthy magma dike that soon grew to 40 kilometers in length. Part of this erupted via a few scattered vents on the surface, but the dike also ran through the Hayli Gubbi volcano and caused cracks to form and gas to rise from said cracks on the outskirts of Afdera town. During the subsequent 4 months, magma mixing of the basalt intrusion with a pre-existing trachytic magma body underneath the Hayli Gubbi shield volcano occurred, until it finally explosively broke through the surface in the largest explosive volcanic eruption of 2025. Wide swaths of Ethiopia, Eritrea, and even Yemen were coated in a layer of volcanic ash, large areas near its summit were impacted by pyroclastic flows, and three large craters up to 1,365 feet wide formed. Our last big story was that in Indonesia, on November 19th, a major Merapi-type volcanic eruption took place. As much of its summit lava dome collapsed in bigger and bigger chunks on that day, pyroclastic flows continued reaching farther and farther away from its summit, eventually even overtopping the edge of specific river channels. Pyroclastic flows eventually reached up to 17.4 kilometers or 10.8 miles southeast of Semeru's active crater, resulting in the destruction of more than two dozen structures, but thankfully causing no fatalities. Thanks to everyone for watching my video content during 2025, and a happy new year to you all!